हाय, गुड इवनिंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। कैन यू हियर मी? Dr. Kumar is here. Hi, sir. Good evening. Anmol.
हेलो मनी।
या हाय सर, गुड इवनिंग।
गुड इवनिंग,
थैंक यू फॉर कमिंग सर।
वेलकम।
सर द स्टूडेंट्स हैव जॉइंड।
ओके, सो वी विल वेट फॉर अ व्हाइल फॉर देम।
नहीं सर, वी कैन स्टार्ट।
वी कैन गिव देम इट्स ओके, है ना? आई थिंक दे आर 91 एंड दे आर स्टिल जॉइनिंग।
या
Good evening, Arpan. Good evening, Anjali. Good evening, Aarti. Good evening, Anukriti. Dalabani, my sound is okay?
Perfect, clear, sir.
Good.
I'm not able to see you, sir.
I have muted the video.
Okay. But your sound is perfect.
Yeah. So,
please. Sir.
Yeah.
We can start, sir.
Okay.
There is a question from Anjali. She is saying, I have doubt about how dual specialization will go.
Okay.
So I believe, sir, you can address to them and then we can take question answer session.
Yeah, sure.
Thank you.
Good evening, all. I'm talking to you from Kolkata, from my hotel room. And five-star hotels have a culture of little dim light in the room. Not very bright light in the room. Let me first congratulate you all and upon having joined ISBM. You have joined one of the finest institutions with a group of finest educators who work with great sense of responsibility towards the students. And we make every possible effort that should be done to build a professional career of our students. At ISBM, you would never find ISBM short of doing what should be done for your good career. We understand that students come from a diverse background, very different background, the social education, culture, all kinds of differences. We understand those differences. And we work with them inside the classroom. We work with them outside the classroom. We create a lot of support system for you to cope with a good MBA program. Not just a PGDM or MBA program, but a good PGDM program, a good MBA program. Because we recognize that every student who joins ISBM has a serious interest in career. Every student who joins ISBM is very important to us. You know, we do not want any student of ISBM to fail in professional life. So we are very, very responsible in our approach to students. We do everything that we must do. We also seek from you everything that you should do to build your good career. So in that sense, you are joining an institution where you can be very, very confident that you will build a very, very good career, not just good career, a very, very good career. If you want to understand how good career has been students build, check ISBM alumni. Look at them and you'll discover that depending on the number of years that they have been in industry, all of them, all of them who have joined professional career have done well in professional career. Some of them who come from family business, go back to their family business. And the ones who have gone back to their family business, they have expanded their father's business and are diversified the business into multiple areas. I know of ISBM alumni who got into entrepreneurship and business, and they have the highest that I know of is a guy who does her annual revenue of more than 1,000 crore. He's a 2004 pass out of company and became an entrepreneur after working for a few years, does in excess of 1,000 crore annual revenue. And I mean, there are guys who are 500 crores, 600 crores. There are also people who are probably very new, one, 2 or 3 years in the entrepreneurial venture, so they could be smaller. But no matter what they do, whatever they pursue, they pursue it very successfully. And that is because as an institution, we think it's our job to build your talent, to build your business talent. It's our responsibility that we must build your style. Because you cannot do well without learning, without being talented. Be it in a job in industry, very large number of ISBM alumni work with multinational corporations, and they work with the best of the companies in the world. Among MNCs, I can only say that if you check 70 to 80% MNC, 70 to 80% will have ISBM alumni. You know, the ones who passed out 10, 12, 14, 15 years ago, their career, you compare with the best of the institutions, you compare with the top institutions, you will find they have a similar career. They're comparable, similar. So expect good things to happen to your professional life. You know, ISBM keeps your future safe. We train you in a way, in a manner that you can be absolutely certain about a future. ISBM students are very confident, they're very competent, and our recruiters have a lot of praise for them. In fact, today we are at a stage where many times, many recruiters, we do not approach them, but they approach us, saying they would want to recruit at ISBM. I'll tell you, a recent addition has been a bank called South Indian Bank. A South Indian Bank wrote to us, saying that they want to recruit from ISBM. And you know, they have come now at the stage when ISBM placement is almost about to get over. Just about 15 or 20%, 15, 17% students are left to be placed. Now they have come at almost the end of the placement of 1921 batch. Okay. And they're making an offer of 10 lakh. CTC offer of 10. Just today, YJU's picked up some of the ISBM students on a CTC of 10 over 10 lakh. Okay, So I think you should expect that if you study in an institution like ASBM, right things will happen. You will grow in life, you will grow in career. Your future is safe. Sometimes some students, some have the anxiety that if I have taken a bank loan, am I taking a risk? As an ASBM student, you're not taking a risk. All you need to do is make sure you're focused, make sure you study right, make sure you do everything that we as an institution want you to do. Hum education samajhte hain aur aap hamari baat suno, apna dimag lagane ki zarurat hi nahi. You will never fail. In ASBM, we always say that you cannot fail unless you are determined to fail in your life. Okay. So it's a very, very responsible approach. Our alumni have grown very big in the status. If you look at some of the oldest alumni, some of the older alumni who may have passed on in 2002, 3, 4, 5, 6, who are for 15, 17 years in industry. You know, today they work on salary levels of a crore annually, or some of them in one and a half crore. Okay. And a crore and 1.5 crore in India. I'm not talking about overseas posting. Those who will have overseas posting probably, and who are in overseas careers, probably much more. You are doing an MBA program. MBA program is meant for economic value. It's meant for building a career. If you don't grow in industry, if you don't grow in career, you cannot have economic. So you must learn to join the right company, you must compete to join the right company, you must join the right job and learn how to grow in the career. You know, your economic value, economic well-being comes from there. Okay. If you look at ASBM alumni, when I look back and my assessment is that if you add 5 years early, year one, year two, after passing out your PGDM program from ASBM, first year, second year, third year, fourth year, fifth year, sir. Okay. If you add all 5 years, the range of the total income of 5 years, total income of 5 years will be anything from 35 to 40 lakhs on the lower side, going to about 80, 90 lakhs to a crore in India. 80, 90 lakhs in India. Cumulative salary of 5 years. So where is the risk? Banks give you a loan for 5 years. So where is the risk? Okay. Now, I'm not talking about those alumni who got posting overseas. I'll share with you current batch. There is an alumni, I forget her name, from Odisha. She has joined a company called Alten. It's a technology, European technology company. You know, the day she joined her, within 2 or 3 days of briefing, induction, the girl was told that, look, if you do well in your career in Alten, if you do well in Alten, and by the end of third year, which means your fourth year salary will be around 19 to 20 lakhs. That's fourth year, 1 year, sir. So you add, imagine if you added all 4 years, you will anytime be at something like 60 to 7, 65 lakhs cumulative salary. So where is the risk? Where is the rest? But you need to understand one thing. We educate you, we train you. And as much as we take the responsibility to educate you, train you, do good things to you, you also must take the responsibility to commit to your learning process. Not make compromises, not do mischiefs, and make sure that you remain committed to the learning process. You know, I met in the interview, we did not take this one, a student in one of the interviews. You know, he says to me, that are you very strict about attendance? Are you very strict about it? My answer to him was, if you are studying in, let's say, ISBM Nandi, how much money are you going to spend completing your program? In ISBM programs are expensive, 12, 14 lakhs you spend, and you spend so much money to bunk classes. Do you want to spend so much money to bunk classes? Yeah, you want fun in life. Nobody says don't have fun. But you have a weekend for the fun. Do you need to bunk classes for fun? So you need to also be very, very sincere. As my program is very rigorous, as my program is ensures that you learn. Okay. After all, MBA is not meant just for a job. Okay. I mean, just for a job, you will get a job. Okay. But MBA is meant for a career. Value lies in the career building. You go to C grade colleges, you will get an MBA passing out of C grade colleges, who even at the end of 3, 4, 5 years work for 25,000 or salary. You will see MBAs who have worked for 10 years, and they will probably, they are very happy if they get salary like 40,000, 45,000. But is that MBA? Is that really an MBA? At the end of 5 years, 6 years, 10 years, you should be hitting salary levels beyond 1.5 lakh, 2 lakhs, and likes of. So the MBA must be for career. MBA must be for value. MBA must be for enriching your own life. Let me share with you, and again, I may have shared with you before as well, about 8,000 of ISBM alumni control their own personal wealth will be in excess of about 20,000. So I feel very proud. I feel very good. I feel very good that you have created people who are so well off in life. People who have done so well in life. And so you should understand that MBA program is meant for a career. And it's not just a job. It's not just a job. Your job to supplement. I mean, in ISBM, you will always get a job. There's no issue about a job. Some will get early, some will get a little late, but all get a job. Also remember that careers are competitive. But we must learn to compete. In ISBM, we train into ambition, aspiration, competitive behavior, benchmarked standards. You know, in competition, it doesn't work to say, oh, I am good. Yeah, everybody is good. But am I good enough to cross a benchmark? Let's say as a student, you play sports. You play cricket, you play badminton you play, some of you play tennis or different kinds of sports. So I may be good at college level, am I good for district level? I may be good at district level, am I good for state level, or am I good for national level? So each of these have a different benchmark. You know, we are talking at a time when you could be watching IPL. So you, in 20 overs, you can make 200 runs. I think the other day, Delhi won, I suppose, if I'm not mistaken, against someone, or Calcutta won against Chennai. When Chennai made, no, or one of these, when they made almost 196 runs. And the other one, and they lost at 196. So in competition, the benchmarks are, I'm good is not enough. I'm good, good is not enough. Do I compete at a bench? That approach must be learned. You must learn that competition is about bench. So Ajram is a great learning place. You should always think that once you are in ASBM, all you need to do is be sincere, be focused, do what you are expected, what you are required. Rest will happen in life to you. It will always happen to you in life. I hope you all, I am sorry I did not begin by introduction. Okay, so let me introduce myself at this stage. I'm Dr. Pramod Kumar. I'm founder and group president of ASBM as a group. ASBM has multiple campuses, Pune, Bangalore, Pune, Calcutta, Bangalore, and Murshi in Pune. Pune has two campuses, Nande and Murshi. So four campuses. I have a PhD from IIT Bombay. I started my professional career from Ahmedabad. After my PhD, my first job was at Ahmedabad. My area of interest is human resource management, which is not the focus in Ahmedabad. So I left Ahmedabad and I joined XLR. I was a professor in XLRI for 10 years, almost 10 years. I was also out of 10 years, toward the last 4 or 5 years, I was the chairperson for campus placement of XLR. I've been a consultant with more than 80 companies in India and outside India, named the multinationals like Hindustan Unilever, Standard Chartered Bank, GlaxoSmithKline, Beecham, GSK, and several others, Indian companies like Banking, ICICI Bank, Tata Motors, Tata Steel, and host of them. Indian companies, public sector like NTPC, BHEL, NTPC, and several of them. One industry to across, from entertainment industry like Z Network, Captain Work for Z Network. So from one end to the other end, almost all kinds of industry I've worked with. My consulting has been in human resource management, human resource planning, talent management, performance management, issues like that. So I've worked with a very large number of companies across a variety of sectors. And I'll close by talking at this stage. And you could ask me questions that will interest you. Some of you, put in the message box, good evening, sir, in the beginning. I did reply to you by voice, saying good evening. Those of you who may have written that later than I saw the chat box, the good evening to all of you. And Dolamani,
Yes, sir. I will take down the questions, sir, so that you can answer. So there are many, many questions where students wanted. Can you hear me, sir?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Yeah, thank you. So there are many questions where students want to understand if it will be offline course, online course, and how ISBM is handling the COVID.
Okay.
That's 80% of the questions. I mean, that's the common 80% questions that they have, that it will be online, offline, and how ISBM is handling COVID situation and things. These are the, I mean, core questions.
Okay.
I request you to see.
A question by Anjali on dual specialization. What was that?
Yeah, Anjali want to ask how dual specialization will go. Okay. I mean, how dual specialization will run? How is the program will be run in dual specialization?
Okay. So can I quickly answer that question before?
Yeah, please. Please.
Okay. Anjali, you are supposed to choose two specialization. What you must do is the two of them must be one of your interest. Two, you should also look at they are offer career building or career building. So they support each other. They support each other. They blend each other with each other well. See, you are doing an MBA program. So don't look at an easy way out. Okay, one specialization is easy, so I take that. Don't look at easy. Look at build a combination which is good for careers. In any case, you will have to choose one specialization which will be fixed at this stage. Once you join, you can choose the second specialization. You can even change the second specialization. You can choose all specializations of equal value. So there's no such thing like one is a specialization has is number one and the second is number two. So one has more weightage, second has less weightage. No, both have the same weightage. So going forward, if you decide, suppose you took marketing and finance, and you decide that I want to take a job in marketing and not in finance, you can do that. Or suppose you took HR and marketing, and going forward, you decided that I want to take the job in HR and not in marketing. You can do that. So both specialization will go on your certificate, but your career can be in any of the two specialization, depending on your choice. That decision is your decision. Okay, ISBM does not interfere with your decision. You need guidance, we will guide. If you need guidance as to which should be my second specialization, we'll always guide. Okay. So opt for any specialization that you think at this stage you think you'd want to study. Keep one thing, all of you keep one thing in mind. You are doing MBA. You're doing MBA for a career. You're not choosing courses for the hobby's sake. So let's say I was good at dancing, I love music, so let me take media. No. You should be seriously interested in media, and you should be seriously interested in career in media, then take media. Okay. Or I am good at people, so I take a job. That's not the way. Think about a serious career. What do you want? What do you expect out of it? Okay, and accordingly taken. Okay, Devamani.
Yes, sir.
Are they most in COVID?
Yeah. I mean, that is a very important issue that you need to address. I mean, all are thinking it will be online, offline, and when can they come to campus? What is the strategy for COVID that we are doing?
Say, let me. Yes.
Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Yeah, thank you.
Let me begin by first saying that we have been now 1.5 years, no, almost 1 year, right? Yeah, March 20 to 21 years. We've been 1 year in COVID. Now, I mean, yeah, the whole world has been in 1 year in COVID. So in a way, COVID has become a fact of life. ठीक है, तो ट्रीट कोविड लाइक एनी अदर इलनेस, ओके, यस, वी नीड टू बी केयर, वी नीड टू बी टेक प्रिकॉशन. देयर आर टू इंपॉर्टेंट इश्यूज अबाउट इट. वन इज व्हाट वी विल डू एज एन इंस्टीट्यूशन. टू, ऑफ कोर्स यू सी वी हैव टू फॉलो द लॉ ऑफ द लैंड, व्हाट डिसीजन गवर्नमेंट विल टेक. ओके, माय ओन गेस इज, my own understanding is, and the little that I keep meeting people, little that I understand, government is very, very keen to allow schools and colleges to open completely. Okay. Now you see, government of India has taken a new decision on vaccination, saying everyone above 18 is allowed to take vaccination. That's point one. Point two, they have taken the decision that by June, they want to cover 50 crore people. India has by this time covered about 13, 14 crore people, okay, which is less than 10% of India's population. Which is just about 10% of India's population. We should have done at least 40% by this time. If you look at the countries like US and Europe, all countries which have done about 40%, 35, 40, 45%, their incidence of COVID has dropped considerably. For example, in India, you still have 2.8 lakh new patients every day. But look at United States, which has 70,000 patients a day. Okay. So is Europe. That is because those guys have completed almost 50% of their population vaccination. For reasons variety, we were lagging behind. Now the government says 18 years and above, from 1st May, everybody can take COVID vaccination. My recommendation to all of you who are in ASVM, do that as the first thing. Do that as the first thing, because the government will allow opening and say, but vaccination is important. Okay. So as soon as it opens on the 1st May, go ahead and take vaccination. And 6 weeks later, you are supposed to take second. By mid-June, take second vaccination. You are all set to come to the campus. Okay. So that is one important thing that I would suggest you to do. Because in any case, I think there is some projection. Yesterday only I was listening to news or reading somewhere, one of the IITs, I don't remember IIT Bombay or IIT Delhi, one of these IITs have come up with a forecast saying next 10 to 15 days, there will be a drop in COVID. Because we are already hitting the peak, now there will be a drop. Let's hope that drop happens. But do not miss the vaccination. I emphasize to you, do not miss the vaccination. Go ahead and take it. As far as the ASVM is concerned, we will do offline. We are determined that we want to do offline. Okay. No matter any condition that the government will want us to fulfill, we are ready to fulfill all conditions that are required to do offline. Now, we have even this year taken great care of our students from COVID. In March 20, when lockdown was declared, over some 60 odd students could not go home. They still lived in the hostel. And they went home only by June, when the lockdown opened and they could get the ticket to go. But nobody, we had zero incidents of COVID. After that, you see, this academic year, obviously, by government regulations, we are not allowed to call students to the hostel, so we didn't call anybody. But there have been students who, for a reason variety, one or the other, they came over to Pune. And then they requested us if they can live in hostel. But at one stage, we had some 70, 80 students living in the hostel. And we had zero, we had a zero incidence of COVID all through the year. So we have very strong COVID protocol. We have a doctor in the campus. We have in about 500-700 meter, less than a kilometer distance, we have a symbiosis, a medical college, and hospital right next to ISBM campus. So the driving time from the campus to symbiosis would be 2 to 3 minutes, and definitely not more than 4 or 5 minutes. Okay. You can even walk down to symbiosis in 5, 7, 10 minutes. Okay. And it's a well-equipped hospital. So we have a very good healthcare support system. We have ensured that hygiene is managed and maintained. So all kinds of steps we have taken. We can only tell you that we'll be fully prepared to make sure that you are safe in ISBM. Okay. We have three hostels, three inside the campus, two boys and one girls hostel inside the campus, one hostel just outside the building, just the 10 meters away from the ISBM campus gate. You know, like this year, the hostel which was outside the campus gate, we also kept it a backup hostel in case anyone gets COVID, we will shift that person to that hostel so that the infection does not spread. And disinfecting entire campus is a very, very regular affair. You want, I can send you the pictures. Dolamani, the admin keeps sending pictures. Do they send?
Yeah. I have. Definitely, I'll forward them to them.
Forward them those pictures of
sure.
Disinfection of the campus. And sure. It's a very, very regular thing done. It's not something.
We do 4 times in a week.
Yeah.
Almost every day.
Yes. So, you are well taken care of. ISBM does every effort. And let me also tell you this, we're extremely caring institution when it comes to students' well-being. Extremely caring. Okay. Leave aside COVID. That's a this year affair. In the past also, students can fall sick. Students can have they have had an accident or they fell sick. We are very quick to respond. ISBM administration, ISBM faculty, for any reason you have as a student, you are admitted to the hospital. Administration, people in administration will stand by you 24/7. They will sit on the head of hospital to make sure that you are handled well. As your faculty will make, they are faculty who will visit you in the hospital, who will go and see you. And if you are admitted for any critical reason, then even I visit. Even I go to the hospital. So it's a very warm and caring institute. Like I said to you, we are very responsible. You're very responsible. You're not only a student to us, you know, you're a member of this institution today. And once you are in ISBM and once you are ISBMite all your life, so our relationship is not 2 years. You know, we should be able to connect with each other. Once you pass out 5 years from after passing out, 10 years after passing out, 20 years after passing out. You know, one of the alumnus in Singapore, you know, he and his wife, both are ISBM alumnus. So his wife turned 40, and this guy hosted a party for him. And which means she passed out in 2003, I guess. The guy who passed out in 2002, the girl lady passed out in 2003, and the guy hosted a party in Singapore. And he said, "I want to do everything for Manmohan. I want to give surprise to him." Okay. He called me from Singapore, saying, "Will you come for her 40th birthday? Will you travel to Singapore for her 40th birthday? Manmohan keeps talking about you. In several conversations, we talk about you. Will you travel to Singapore for her 40th birthday?" I said, "Yes, I will." So Nimish was quick to process my visa online, forward me my visa. I went to Singapore, spent a couple of days with him. So it's our relationship very long. It's not a... I mean, in ISBM, you are not a two-year relationship, okay? And there is, any relationship is valuable only if we both value it, isn't it? So don't worry. In ISBM, you are safe. Do not worry. I want to assure all guardians, tell your parents, probably we will do for you much more than what they will do. Okay. Any other question, Dolamani?
Yeah. When the classes will going to start offline? Any date you can suggest? Any month?
Our planned date is mid-June. Okay. Though we wanted to start from 7th June, I'm sure your letter might say 7th June. Have you written 7th June in there?
Yes. The letter has been 7th June.
7th June. But 7th June could probably be a little too early. So, given the scenario. But if given the government preparedness, if it gets deferred by another 1 or 2 weeks, by all means, I expect classes to begin early July, mid-June to early July. But let me assure you, take vaccination. I'm very confident government will put vaccination as a condition. Even this time when they allowed primary schools and all to open, you know, schools, early schools, some of them were allowed to open. You know, one condition was that there should be testing of all faculty, all teachers and the staff should go through COVID test and they should be negative. Then, you know, even for industry, they have said, okay, they should go through COVID test, they should be negative, and the test should be done every 15 days. Let me share with you, from February till yesterday, I think, day before yesterday, okay, I have taken COVID test myself 7 times, but that's because I'm traveling a lot. Okay, so I've taken 7 tests 2 days back because I wanted to travel to Calcutta. I needed the test. Okay, and all 7 times I've been negative. Okay, so I think in ISBM we emphasize on good healthcare. We also have a doctor on campus. In our own campus, we have a doctor available to you 24/7. So we expect to open by mid-June to early. We will definitely, I am very confident that we'll have offline classes. Okay.
Sir, how is the placement and Dutch COVID impacted the placement?
ISBM did not affect the COVID. Those who lived in the hostel, it has not affected our placement. I told you, 85% of students have been placed. Very few students are left to be. Okay. And we still have a company's recruit. I shared with you when I was talking to you how South Indian Bank has just about a week or so back, about 10 days back, approached us about recruiting on a salary level of 10 lakh. Okay. So we do not really have a placement problem. Okay. Sometimes some of the students, it's a competitive scenario. So you see, when you have 300 students, or as your Mande Murshi put together 400 students, so there will always be a first student placed and last student be placed. You will be the first one, you will be the last one. That issue obviously is your own competitive performance within your peer group. Okay. But you will get placed. So we have only 12-13% placed, yet to be placed. We don't have many places. So in that sense, COVID has not affected. Yeah, there may be a mix of industry. Let's say, for example, less recruitment in consumer electronics, less recruitment in FMCG, higher recruitment in banking, higher recruitment in technology companies and services. But we have had consulting companies, company like Deloitte picked up 6 students, company like Pricewaterhouse picked up, I think I remember all campuses put together, they picked up some 40 students. Okay.
38 students.
That's Pune and another 6 from Calcutta.
Yes.
So from ISBM as a group, they picked up so many. Okay. The ICICI big bank picked up a lot of people. Okay. ISBM doesn't have really as much challenge of COVID. ISBM does not have as much challenge of COVID. That 12-15% of students who are not placed so far, they all could have been placed. They all could have been placed. But all said and done, these guys studied their second year from home. So obviously, some degree of seriousness is affected. Let's say, in some companies, some of the guys, they had online company presentation and they did not shave and sat on the presentation. Company didn't like it about it. Okay. When you live at home, maa-baap ke saath personal discipline thoda niche se to jata hai, hai ki nahi? Mom, dad ki baat sabhi log to nahi sunte, hai na? कोई कोई टाइम पे उठ जाता है, कोई कोई देर से उठता है, यू स्टार्ट लेजिंग. सो लिटिल इंपैक्ट ऑफ दोस थिंग्स, नॉट कोविड. ऑल द गाइस आर नॉट सो फार हु डोंट वर नॉट प्लेस, इट इज प्राइमरली बिकॉज ऑफ अ लिटिल इनडिसिप्लिन दैट दे डिस्प्ले, बट वी आर टाइटनिंग देम अप. They're tightening them up, there are 3 students or so. We disallowed them from campus placement. We took a very firm stand on indiscipline by the students in campus placement. So now things are, these guys are also will get. Within the last 2 days, I'm talking 85% is 3-4 days old information. Last 2 days are itself, TAC Nielsen, Nielsen, Market Research Company, इलेक्शन इलेक्शन रिजल्ट्स में आएगा, आज तक एसी नेल्सन सर्वे और एबीपीएलसी एसी नेल्सन सर्वे वो सब आएगा. एसी नेल्सन इज अ मार्केट रिसर्च कंपनी, दे पिक्ड अप सम 4-5 स्टूडेंट्स 2 डेज बैक. ओके अभी लाइक आई टोल्ड यू व्हाई यू पिक्ड अप 4-5 स्टूडेंट्स जस्ट यस्टरडे. ओके सो एवरी डे इट्स हैपनिंग, सो इट्स अ नॉन इशू. The Alten has come back again. You see, first time they interviewed our students was in November. They asked for early joining. We allowed early joining. Our students have done very, very well. So Alten seriously wants to recruit more people from high school. So they came back again to recruit. And I think their presentation was a day for yesterday. So either the interview must be over by today or might happen in next couple of days. And I'm very confident Alten will pick up another 6-7 students from ISBM. ISBM talent is for any company you talk to, they like ISBM students much, much more than many other business schools. Because ISBM students learn right things. They learn really right things. Okay, any other question? COVID has not affected.
Yes. How we had handled summer intensive if the students had not came?
See, students not coming, their internship interview and offer happened online. Okay. But because government removed lockdown from June, May, the lockdown was withdrawn. Companies are allowed to get people to work, get back to work. Many of the interns were working from the company. Some may have still worked, done some work for some time, some work work from home, but a lot of them have been working from office, workplace. For example, we have this guy, we have what is this, Conagra Food, we have some interns in Conagra Foods. So one of the guys who interacts with me very often, he's also a member of placement team of the current batch, first year batch.
Yes.
Rishikesh. So he is in HR. So he has been placed in a plant.
Thermex.
So Conagra Food plant is in Gujarat. So he has been posted in plant in Gujarat. Thermex in Pune. They are working from the office. So similarly, many other companies. Okay. Once recruited for internship, then obviously the company, based on situation from time to time, they take their decision about how you will work. Most of them were working offline. Okay, large number of them were working offline from office. Probably now that government has again done something, so there may be a little next 10-15 days work from home might have come in. But if you are in manufacturing and sales and marketing, you will always have offline. Okay. Any other question, Dulamani?
Yes. How is the placement in HR?
HR placement will be, as a placement will only be good. Don't worry. For HR or marketing, finance or something. Okay. When you are coming, joining ISBM, ISBM knows that you have got to be placed. Yeah. I tell you, out of about 40, 42 students, probably we have just 8-9 students yet to be placed. Okay. So you decide. And these 8-9 also, Yeah, we have a Kotak Bank interview scheduled. We have enough companies scheduled for HR. For example, Byju's is also scheduled for HR. They want to pick up about 4 people in HR from ASBA. You see, ASBA is among the best 4 or 5 institutions in HR in India. Okay. And ASBA alumnus in HR have been on the top of the business. Placement is not so much of an issue. If you perform well, you will be early. Okay. It's a peer level competition. Okay. You can be a little early, you can be a little late. I mean, there have been ASBA students who got placed in October. There have been guys who have been placed in got placed in October. People who got placed in November, December, January. And like I said to you, about 12-13% people are, 10-12% probably, 10-12% are still waiting. So, ho jayega, wo tension nahi hai. When you join ASBM, as placement should not be an issue. How well you compete and prepare yourself, of course, is an issue, but placement is enough. What else?
So, some have doubts in supply chain. How is the placements and how is the career in supply chain?
Hello. Supply chain placement doubt. Why? Okay. Supply chain program of ASBM by industry is seen as among the best 2 programs. Okay. It is among the very, very high profile. See, you must understand, by taking supply chain as an option is not enough. You should be hard working. So, not even supply chain. I think almost all students, maybe 3-4 students may be unplaced still, but almost all are placed. I don't think there's a issue, even in supply chain. I do not have exact precise figure, but it is not more than 5 students who are unplaced. Out of probably 30 students?
No, so I have the data. Out of 30, only 3 are left.
Okay. So that's the data.
Sir,
and 3 also must have been through comes 6, 7, 8 interviews. I can bet you on that.
Out of 3, 1 is looking for self-placement. He wants to join his dad business.
Okay. So only 2 are left.
Yeah.
See, kabhi-kabhi wo bhi hota hai. Students are either abhi very select. You see, sometimes some students make certain mistakes. Let's say, for example, I'm very good. I have a target. I want to do XYZ company. Now, I have companies coming in October, November, December, January, and I know that company will come at the end of January or early February. Okay. Now, I'm not applying to other companies, sitting and waiting for that. And in some cases, you see, you can be confident, but you can't be overconfident. In some cases, having waited so long, they didn't clear that company. They didn't clear that company. अब बोलो क्या करना तो ऑब्वियसली आई मीन सम केसेस आर आल्सो लाइक दिस आई डोंट वांट टू नेम यू द स्टूडेंट्स आई मीन दे आर वेरी ब्राइट स्टूडेंट्स देयर इज नो डिनाइंग टू दैट दे आर वेरी वेरी ब्राइट द सो इट्स आई मीन इट्स आल्सो योर ओन प्लेसमेंट स्ट्रेटजी एज बीन हैज अ प्लेसमेंट प्लान एंड स्ट्रेटजी फॉर यू यू हैव योर ओन प्लान एंड स्ट्रेटजी एज वेल. Okay, so some of them may be waiting to be placed because they did not clear so far the company, but some of them may have miscalculated, misjudged, and waited for a company that comes little later. Yeah, and which they didn't clear. Okay, any other question?
There is an interesting question. what is the designation that they get after joining the company, like management trainee and all. So what is the level where will they get placement?
See, that, then you join as a management trainee. Okay. You join at the level of management trainee. See, I'll tell you, your range of salary will be 6 lakhs to 20, 18, 19, 15, 18, 19, 20 lakhs. Obviously, you are taken at a level which is good level. Okay. As them is either tier 1 or tier 2 level placement. So, and most of them, almost all of them get, once they complete training, they are confirmed as assistant manager. Okay. Rest is titling of the designation can be very different. Let's understand this. For example, head HR. In head HR, in one company, is called chief people officer. In another company, he is called director HR. In still another company, he is called vice president HR. You know, some of the banks like Deutsche Bank and all, they call him managing director, human resource manager. So we title could be head to sabhi head HR. So that's in private industry, there is no standardized title. Okay.
Yeah. Any other questions, guys? I think we have answered almost all. Graduation. Sir, how will our graduation marks impact in our placement?
This is a good question. I hope you got a first class. Okay. Don't worry. Once you're selected in ASMIM, we'll do a lot of things for you. See, when you have a master score, 10th, 12th or graduation score, see here. So let's say if there is a company which says, I want to recruit people who have brought first class, and if you have one second class. Okay. Then obviously, it affects you. Now, if generally speaking, if your second class is in graduation, we are able to manage it. Even in plus two, if it is, but that's a little tough thing to manage. But if it is in graduation, we are able to manage. Because there are two kinds of companies. One, who have a policy, human resource policy, they say that they want to throw out first class. So if it is a policy, so it's difficult for them to change the policy for one student or two students or one institution. But many companies, because you see, especially when you apply in HR, marketing and finance, and there are 150 students applying and they can't interview 150, they want to reduce the list to 50, 60, or 70. So the easiest way is to look at academic performance and say, okay, all who are true or first class. In such cases, we are able to persuade it to a company saying that you cannot have a thinking like this. Which they also listen. Okay. But don't worry. Don't worry about all. Whatever we can do, everything that we can do, let me tell you this. Your recruitment by a company is a very professional. It's a very professional relationship between ASMIM and the company. We understand that the company does not do a favor to ASMIM because they are recruiting. They are recruiting because we have good talent. And they want good talent. It's not that they are doing a favor to ASMIM and therefore they come to it. Okay. Companies are not doing toss a coin and say, okay, ASMIM, toss a coin, head we go, tail we don't go. It's a conscious decision. ASMIM has brilliant alumni performance. And as I said to you, look at MNCs, best of the MNCs, 70 to 80% have asthma mellitus. Some at the junior level, some at the middle level, and some at the level of vice presidents and directors. तो बोलो अगर asthma में student is a vice president and director, आप कैसे बोलेगा कि asthma is not good for me, for my company to recruit? If asthma alumni is good to become a director in your company, how a new asthma student is not good to be a management trainee in your company? है ना? तो asthma, I mean you are at a solid platform. You are a solid platform, so don't worry. You look at top companies, you will always find 70-80% of the top companies. You will always find MNCs, by all means, Indian companies may have ek do miss ho sakta hai. But even within Indian companies, 70-80% you will find. Big companies, top companies, you will find as well. So tension, itna tension ki baat nahi. Hai na? Are there any questions? If they are talking from home, do the parents have any questions?
Check some parents, some parents have replied that this is a very nice session, and I mean all the doubts have been clear and they're happy. So I mean there are many messages from the parents.
Please do interact with asthma. My message to the parents is interact with asthma. Bachche ko asthma bhej ke so mat jana. पूछते हो, पूछो बच्चा क्या क्या कर रहा है. इंटरेक्ट विद एस्मा, यू नो, लाइक आई टेल यू, दिस बॉय बसम गॉट प्लेस ओनली डे फॉर यस्टरडे. अबाउट 7-8 days, 10 days बैक, आई वाज वेरी एंग्री. देयर वर 5-6 स्टूडेंट्स, वेरी केयरलेस, वेरी इनडिसिप्लिन हैंडलिंग ऑफ कैंपस प्लेसमेंट. आई वाज वेरी एंग्री. And these 7-8 fellows were in Pune. I called them to the campus. I blew my top. I was mad. अभी देखो आजमन में ऐसा नहीं कि you know I'll say वो तुम्हारा नहीं हो रहा है तो हम क्या करें? नहीं, मैं तुम्हारा सर फोड़ दूँगा, तुम कैसे नहीं पढ़ेगा? Okay, left to me. I love. So I called them all in the campus and I said no. So I spoke to Basam's father. You know, he sent me a very nice message. I'll read out the message. Basam got placed and his father sent me a very nice message today. Mr. Qureshi has sent me this nice message. Most respected sir, my whole family expresses our gratitude and thanks to you. Regards. I replied to him, you're most welcome and I'm very happy for Basam and you all. Okay. So, I mean, like I said to you, that our relationship is not ki tum aa gaya, class attend kiya, fees de diya, and you grade mil gaya, and you picked up a job. If you flunked in 8-10 interviews, so I tell you, abhi tu fail ho ja raha, to main kya karun tumha? No. No. If you flunk in 10 companies, 15 companies will call you and talk to you and ask you, why did you flunk? Ab kyon fail hua? We'll like to understand. We'll like to do, is there something that we can still do for you? So we do a lot of effort. Let me tell you this. We support students, even students who have got their first job after 30 interviews, 35 interviews. Okay. Asthma ka biggest problem yeh hai ki asthma mein students bahut baar indiscipline place in placement they become real careless and indiscipline kyunki unko yeh lagta ki asthma mein job to milega hi, job to mil hi jayega, college kuch na kuch to karega. This attitude is very rampant. You speak to them, they will tell you college kuch na kuch to karega. So, of course, and we always do. Of course, we like to do. We will like to do. We will not like to leave you alone. Don't worry about it. I want to assure all parents of tension. We like our students to succeed. When our student has sadak pe ghumega, so as them kahi reputation kharab hoga. As them third class college nahi hai. Aap as them mein all parents ko main kehna chahta hu, aap dekh lo aapke city se bahut sare students as them mein padhne aate hain. Delhi NCR se bahut sare aate hain. Lucknow se bahut sare aate hain. Kolkata se bahut sare aate hain. Pura se aate hain. Okay. मुंबई से भी आते हैं. आप देख लो आपके एक अगर आपको मिलेगा एजमेम स्टूडेंट पास आउट होके सड़क पे घूम रहा उसको जॉब नहीं. या आप देख मेरे को बताओ अगर कोई एजमेम स्टूडेंट 6 साल 7 साल 8 साल का एक्सपीरियंस है और उसको 20,000 रुपये या 25,000 या 30,000 रुपये सैलरी मिलता है. एजमेम दैट कैनॉट हैपन टू एजमेम. टेंशन लेने का टाइम जरूरत नहीं है. ओके डोला मनी, एनी अदर क्वेश्चन दैट? सो टू ऑल गार्जियंस एंड पेरेंट्स, फील कॉन्फिडेंस. फील कॉन्फिडेंस. योर
आई थिंक आई वाज चेकिंग ऑल द क्वेरीज. आई थिंक वी हैव सॉल्वड एवरीथिंग. आई थिंक दे आर मोस्ट एक्साइटेड फॉर द कोविड, सो यू हैव सॉल्वड दैट. एंड आई डोंट थिंक सो एनीथिंग लेफ्ट.
Don't worry. ISM is beyond COVID.
There is a good question. Can I say?
Yeah.
Sir, I'm currently working with ENY as an advisory associate. And I'm trying to make a deviation into media and marketing. I mean, he want to understand, is this an ideal choice?
See, marketing, of course, is a good choice. Media, you should take if you have a serious interest in media. If you are taking it for the hobby sake or it's very exciting, so then you can take a couple of courses in media. You see, your second specialization must support your career. Okay? So media goes well with marketing. There's no denying to that. But at the same time, it also limits. Let's say, for example, If you want to join banking, but they will like to take somebody who has done marketing and finance, not marketing and. Okay, if you take marketing and media, then your options are both limited. You will have the option of FMCG, you will have the option of consumer electronics, you will have the option of media companies. You will have the option of services, some of the services, but you will not have the option of technical companies and financial services companies. So, what you dekh lo, you see, let's say, for example, if you want to go to your work experience from ENY and you want to go to Pricewaterhouse, probably Pricewaterhouse, or you want to go to Deloitte, probably they will look at the finance too, marketing finance. So you decide with how, and keep it as a second specialization. Don't take it as a first specialization. Keep it as a second specialization. You can change it even later. Once you join second specialization, you can change for next 4, 5, 6 months. Until you are placed for summer internship, you can still change. I mean, say by the end of second trimester, before and by the end of second trimester, you can change your second specialization. Yeah. So take media as a second specialization. Or aane ke baad decide kar lena if you are not sure right now. Us time pe decide kar lena. Don't worry.
Sir, I think we have cleared all the questions. There is no more questions. I mean, they are saying thanks for the session. All the students are saying thank you for the session to you.
You are most welcome here. I am looking forward to seeing you in person. You see, my life is so tragic, as much as you guys may feel for yourself. you know, the passing out batch, current 1921 batch, we met them in 1920, but not 2021. Okay. 2022 batch, we have not met them in 2021. I'm hoping that I will meet these guys in 21-22. Okay. And I'm absolutely confident and very, very keenly awaiting and looking forward to meeting each one of you on ISBM campus. Look forward to being with you and seeing. ISBM is a great place to be in. It's a great place to study, and it's a great quality of life. Great quality of very, very good quality of life. And very an institution that cares for this student. We value our relationship with our students. So I'm looking forward to seeing you all. Thank you all for joining for this webinar. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir, for your time. It is a wonderful session today. Yes, sir, you can leave. All the questions are solved.
Right. Okay.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, Dulamani. I think.